from bad...
You know, the relationship is one that's on the way back.
...to worse.
You think he lied to you?
I don't think. I know.
The French president accusing Scott Morrison of lying to him over the abandoned submarine deal.
When we have respect, you have to behave in line and consistently with this value.
Speaking of awkward, our PM at times found himself a little short on mates at the G20. Until... Quad goals! Australia teaming up with China, Russia and India to oppose a deadline to phase out coal and reduce methane emissions by 2030.
What Australia continues to do, which is nothing other than to dig into dark holes of poison for itself and for the planet, is completely irresponsible.
It doesn't bode well for COP26, which overnight kicked off with a bang.
We know that this COP, COP26, is our last best hope.
If Glasgow fails, then the whole thing fails.
Let us pray so that the cry of the earth and the cry of the poor shall be heard.
Protesters joining world leaders pleading for strong action at the pivotal climate conference.
Stop talking, start acting.
Deadlines that people are actually going to stick to.
We are looking forward for action from here.
Our guy in Glasgow, Scott Dooley, there as it all unfolds.
Streamers kind of take me out of the performance a bit. Just a bit.
Do you know Wonderwall?
Everyone, like, coming together is amazing, yeah.
I'm going to be very honest. With your accent and those drums, no one in Australia understood a word you said.
No, it's other music.
Okay.
Well, straight out of Glasgow, it is the Pro-Days COP26 correspondent, Scott Dooley. Dools, what's the vibe now? Is everyone really excited, hopefully, to save the world from climate catastrophe?
The locals aren't exactly into it. Like, it's actually funny, the Glasgow locals have a similar response to Australian government where they're like, we need to do something, just not here. So everyone's a bit annoyed because there's like road closures and the trains aren't working and it's making everything a bit of a nightmare. The flip side of that is people are making a fortune renting their flats as Airbnbs. The guy that checked me into mine literally picked up a bag and said, I'm going to Cancun. And so, you know, it's been a mixed response.
Dools, there's been a bit of backlash for Australia and our climate policy. How have we been received over there?
Well, Tommy, people know. Like, the taxi driver just then was asking, like, if Morrison was coming. We had another guy who was telling us that the only reason we're here is because the Queen forced Morrison and we had to come and cover him and stuff. So we're not the most popular people here. But we're more popular here than we are in France, so I guess that's a push. What's that?
Scott, it's great to see you there. I didn't realise that you were a climate activist.
Well, Kerry, I figured that we needed one Australian called Scott to come here and care, so I thought that can be me, so here I am.
Well, we'll cross to you throughout the fortnight, Dools. Thanks very much for speaking to us.
See you guys.
The blue with the French is really interesting, isn't it? I mean, Scott Morrison said he definitely told Emmanuel Macron that he was going to walk away from the submarine deal because conventional subs would not work. Macron says he didn't hear that. So there must have been other people in the room. Eventually, we'll know the truth.
Even Biden's come out now and said it was all a bit clumsy.
Well, it could have been clumsy, but I mean...
He thought it was all sorted before the US got involved.
There's a big difference between clumsy and accusing someone of lying.
I know, but Biden's probably playing, you know...
But isn't that what makes it so significant? Like, a foreign leader who's technically an ally doesn't come out and call you a liar unless they really mean to. Like, that's not an accident. You don't slip up and say that in front of the international press,
yeah,
right?
But how can Scott Morrison say that, no, I told him I was backing out of the deal, conventional subs wouldn't work? Now, he's not going to invent that.
No, but it's a weird argument he's running, because on the other hand, he's also saying it's a national security thing. We couldn't discuss these things. Well, if you couldn't discuss, then how is it you say you discussed? It's a very weird situation, and I reckon it could be a problem for Morrison, because can you imagine every attack ad will now say, this is what our allies think of...
Emmanuel Macron needs to be careful, though, given what Australia's done for France in two world wars. There's a lot of Australian blood on the Western Front. I think I would just urge him to back off a bit.
Do you think Australia could have been more careful in the way it handled the subs thing?
Possibly, but I've been to the Western Front. I know what it's like.